serious?
What is up, YouTubers? Dr. C in the house. Thank you very much for tuning in for a first video on the content of this here box. It's that time again. I got a black box and it's an unmarked box, but this is because it's a pre-production sample, this box, or the content of this box. It is from Diatone, as you can see, and it contains the Tycan C3, so the 3-inch Tycan, their CineWhoops, the 2022 version, brand new version, and in this video I'm going to show you what it takes to get it from box to flight. I will also do an actual review of the quadcopter with some tuning and stuff. So in this video we're going to have a look at how easy it is to get this Tycan 3 or Tycan C3 from box to flight. This is a bind and fly version, so it has a receiver. You can get this quadcopter with FR Sky compatible receivers or TBS receivers or without a receiver. And yeah, that's it. We're gonna have a quick look at what you get with this quadcopter. After that, again, I'm gonna show you what it takes to get it up in the air. Here we go. And there you have it, one Tycan C3. So the 2022 version, an upgraded version, or an updated version, and it still does look very much the same, right? It at least looks very similar. So what are the differences between this 2022 version and the old version or the previous version? First thing is that this will only be available as a 6S quadcopter, which is fine to me. There was no real need for a 4S version since the 6S version flies well on 4S as well, right? And if you were to buy the 4S version, you wouldn't be able to fly on 6S. With this one you can fly on 4S, 5S and 6S. So I think it's a good choice from Diatone to only offer the 6S version. Then the second thing is the motors. That's a major upgrade. And I think that will make tuning of this quadcopter easier. These motors are bigger, but mostly different. The previous version had 1606 motors and this one has 2203.5 inch version, so wider motors, which it will provide more torque. And again, I think this version will be easier to tune. And in a minute we will obviously take it up in the air and we'll see if these motors get hot, right? That's one thing that's important. In the previous version, if you didn't use my tune yeah, if you ran it box stock, those 1606 motors would run hot. So yeah, in this video we're gonna fly box stock, so let's see what these motors do. And also you might have noticed that this quadcopter has LEDs in these ducts. Now the previous version was offered with LEDs in the ducts, but that was an upgraded version, if you will, a special version. The base version didn't have LEDs. Now the base version does have LEDs. Okay, what do you get with this quadcopter? You get, as per usual with Diatone quadcopters, you get one set of propellers. These are the Gemfan D76 propellers. These pedals like three blade propellers. I also got six blade propellers. I don't think you will get those in the package. You can order these from Diatone, and I'd say if you order this quadcopter, I'd order these as well. Just to try, it's not expensive, right, propellers? So in this video we will be flying the quadcopter on these, as you get them stock with a quadcopter, but again, I will also be trying these. Interesting, I haven't actually somehow tried these propellers yet on my other quadcopters. Then there's a lot of other stuff with this quadcopter, but it's mostly what you get with all Diatones. You get some documentation, parts list, exploded views, and documentation for the this is for the VTX. There's probably one for the receiver as well, and receiver, tiny receiver, ultra tiny receiver. Okie dokie, you get a general purpose action cam mount, or two actually. No, one, sorry. One general purpose GoPro style action cam mount. Again, you get that with a lot of Dytone quadcopters. You get a USB cable, a USB-C cable. There's a breakout cable in the quadcopters for you to access the USB port easier. So that's nice. This cable, yeah, USB-C. Didn't you already have a USB-C? I had a lot. So yeah, I think they could omit this and maybe add a second set of propellers. Okay, and what is this? This is cabling to hook up receivers. I got the bind and fly version, so I don't need this, but you get that with every Dytone quadcopter. And what is this? This looks like, I'm not sure actually, cabling for LEDs? Could be for LEDs. But again, the quadcopter is already outfitted with LEDs. You get a frequency table, and you only get this with the analog version, right? There's a digital version and an analog version, but this is a frequency chart. And you actually get a keychain cable or ring for it, so you can attach this to your belt or your backpack. That might be an option. And you get a care package. So this contains two battery straps, antenna mounts, antenna tubes, an FPV antenna, and propeller nuts, and always a bunch of tie wraps and anti-skid mat. And this is, and also spare screws. For every screw that's in the quadcopter, you get spares. So that's always a nice care package from Dytone. So then, let's have a look what it takes to get this Tycan C3 up in the air. One thing of note, there's a USB-C connector over here, which is hooked up to the flight controller. Very, very convenient, right? Again, I told you there's a breakout cable, and I'm not sure if you'll be able to see it, but it leads to here. So super duper easy to access the USB port, and that's an upgrade from the previous version, definitely. Okay, regardless, first thing you do is screw on that FPV antenna. You don't wanna accidentally power up your quadcopter without an FPV antenna on it, otherwise you will you might get lucky, but you will probably burn up your VTX, your video transmitter, so you definitely don't want to do that. First action you take is screwing up that FPV. Screwing up? Yeah, attaching that FPV antenna. So the second thing I want to do is bind the receiver, the included receiver, to my radio, right? And I'm hoping I can get to the bind button. All right, I had to have a look off camera where the bind button is. The receiver is actually on the bottom side underneath this top plate over here. And I can access the bind button from underneath, from over here. But not without my head in the shot. So I will do that off camera. Otherwise, well, again, you can get to the bind button if you get the bind and fly version. But otherwise, you could take off the top plate, of course. There's 8 screws. And then your access to the receiver is easier. But again, it's not needed. It would be needed if you want to flash different firmware onto the receiver. So I've got the Dytone MSR receiver, which is RXSR, Everskye RXSR compatible, even to the point that you can flash RXSR firmwares onto it. So if you the firmware on the receiver will be international or FCC. If you want a different firmware on that receiver, again, you can flash RXSR firmware onto that receiver, any firmware. Okay, so I'll bind the quadcopter off screen, and then we'll have a look in Betaflight if what the setup is like of this quadcopter, if we need to tweak anything to get it flight ready. Alrighty, let's hook up the quadcopter to USB 2.2, and there we go. We are in Betaflight, and this quadcopter has a firmware version of 4.2.9, which is decent. No real need to instantly upgrade that firmware, which is nice. So let's see, ports. That doesn't even look remotely correct. Okay, in case you didn't notice, smart audio isn't configured. The receiver is configured, so you would be able to fly, but you can't configure the VTX this way. I am assuming it's on UART 2. So, TBS smart audio. Hachikidei. And yeah, that should work. Okie dokie, we'll save and exit. Hachikidei, and there we go. And okay, configuration then. I did notice that the motor spun up when I got my radio connected to the receiver, so this should all work. I'm gonna put in a name, Taiken3, yay. And yeah, so this receiver that's in the quadcopter is an SBUS receiver, so that's correct. Soft serial is on. I'm not completely sure why, but maybe it's needed, and maybe it's even needed if you want to add an GPS, for instance. Okay, telemetry LED strip is obviously needed for to address those LEDs in the ducts. Telemetry, yeah, so SBUS, right? It's not set up as an F port receiver. If you were to order this quadcopter with an crossfire receiver, telemetry would be well enabled, should be enabled. And the quadcopter comes with a hardware buzzer, so no need to use D-shot buzzer to use the motors as buzzers. Other than that, this looks fine. Okay, yeah, turtle mode. Will you be using turtle mode on a quadcopter like this? Maybe. If you do want that, you'll have to set this arming angle to 180. Yeah, so air mode is always on, dynamic filter. Yeah, looks nice. So far the only omission was that smart audio in the port step, and that could be because I have a pre-production sample here. Could be. I will tell Ditone obviously, so they can address that for their production versions. Okay, this I'm assuming is correct. I won't touch that. PID tune, box stock, as you can tell. So we will see in a minute if this works. Again, with these upgraded motors, the quadcopter should be easier to tune, even to the point that it might fly well on the stock Betafly tune. We will see again in a minute. Filter, also stock, and yeah, everything stock, okay. Receiver, yeah, okay, that worked. Actually, let me show you that it works. I'm gonna hook up a battery. There we go, and you can see that all my inputs work. Hachikidei, and yeah, so that's nice. And the next thing is modes. I did note, yeah, battery connection. Okay, only one mode. Yeah, you don't really need modes, but this is a bit subpar, Ditone. Put in a couple of modes for people to have auto level and maybe beeper. Yeah, beeper. Put in a couple of modes. That would be nice, Ditone. This is points subtracted. Yeah, okay, motors. Okay, the motors worked. OSD is probably stock as well. Yeah, stock Betaflight. Okay, so Ditone doesn't put in a lot of things into the configuration here. And video transmitter, yeah, this I know to be because it's a pre-production sample. If you order this quadcopter, you should definitely get VTX tables already in the quadcopter. So yeah, take this, well, not with a grain of salt. I will put in the VTX tables. Again, if you order this quadcopter from Ditone, it should and probably will get with the video transmitter already set up correctly. An LED strip. Yeah, okay, so, okay. They did put in the LED programming, so that's nice. Obviously, you can change the colors, right? So you can address the colors of those ducts, which is nice. There's also already some one setup here, but yeah, easy to change, so that's nice. And that is basically it. So again, the only omission here is probably, again, hopefully due to this being a pre-production sample, I'll have to set up my VTX. Other than that, yeah, and I will enter my flight modes, the flight modes I always use, and the OSD, I'll put in the OSD I always use. That's not neat, and it's subject to personal taste, right? Maybe you want a very clean OSD anyway. Maybe you want nothing in your OSD, but yeah, flight time and your voltage, I always definitely want that in my OSD. So I have a stock script I always use for that. Yeah, so okay, Diatone. It would be nice to add some things here. I've noticed in previous quadcopters from Diatone as well, there's usually not a whole lot in the configuration. Yeah, okay. So, again, I'll put in my flight modes, my OSD, and I'll set up the VTX, and let's see if the quadcopter flies.
Alrighty, and if you are familiar with my channel, you know that I always do a quick hover test in my lawn over here. Just because I don't want to first charge a battery, then go out to a flying field, and then find out that the quadcopter doesn't even fly, right? So let's do a little bit of a hover test. And it arms, as you can tell, and you can also now see those LEDs. And we'll do a little bit of a longer hover test here to check if the motors don't get hot. It is a noisy quadcopter. Well stable though, very much stable. Not bad at all. Yeah, so completely controllable, it flies. And let's set it down and check the motor temperatures. Bang! Oops. Okay, motor temperature. Oh, those are cool. In fact, I already did a couple of minutes of hovering indoors. And with the previous Taycan, the motors got blisteringly hot indoors after half a minute of flying indoors. With these don't get warm. So that's definitely a win. That's nice. With that said, let's take it out for an FPV flight. Here we go. Alrighty guys. First real FPV flight with the Taycan 2022 version of the C3. Here we go. We are armed and we are indeed up and away. And we've got a sunny day. It is quite cold, by the way, but okay. So, yeah, this is... oh, by the way, this morning, I heard from Diatone that they will ship this quadcopter with a tune. Whether that's my tune or a tune of their own, I don't know. But at least not box stock beta flight, so no tune. Right, so, and okay, so I am flying it beta flight stock. It actually looks pretty okay. I made very sure that I placed the battery so that the quadcopter was balanced. That always helps, definitely with these quadcopters. And it's actually okay. I see a little dribble, a wobble in the pitch axis. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that. Little bit of a dribble, not much, hard to see. You tell me if you see it, but I see a slight wobble in, and that's surprising, in the pitch axis. Most times you see wobbles or oscillations in the bank angle, but not this time. So critical, yeah. Critical. What? my radio said something critical. Not sure what that was. Maybe it's the antenna placement? Oh well. Yeah, this is an Eversky receiver here, or Eversky compatible. But okay, so the quadcopter, it did take some settings to get it flight ready. Okay, our signal low. Not sure why that is. Maybe the antennas of the quadcopter were behind the LiPo, I'm not sure. I'll check that after the flight. My experience with these MSR receivers from Diatone is good, they work. They work just as well as the Eversky receiver, so it must be antenna placement. Okay, so again, it flies and I'm assuming I am pretty sure that they will set up the VTX tables and flight modes, I don't know. I've seen it a couple of times in Diatone quadcopters before that the quadcopter didn't have a lot of flight modes. But this looks just fine. FPV picture is nice, but yeah, it's a sunny day, right? This is not much of a test. And also, these are the RunCam Phoenix version 2 cameras, and they are nice cameras. Yeah, my receiver signal isn't great. I'm not sure why that is. It shouldn't be like this. But this looks okay. So, slight dribble. That means that I will be posting up a video in which I show you a proper tune for this quadcopter. And I'll include that in my review of the quadcopter. Other than that, yeah, a few misses and I should be getting in a Diatone production version of any quadcopter at some point to do this test again, right? And yeah, I'll check the antenna. Other than that, it flies. So my next video on this quadcopter might actually be just a capture with a GoPro 8 on it to see how that works. It's a Cinewoops, right? So it should be able to capture nice videos. For now, I'd like to thank you for watching. If you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.